welcome back to my YouTube channel, Jerry Make It Easy. Again, on the 14th of July 2020, IT people got shocked by news coming from the Microsoft regarding CVE-2020-1350 with a CVSS rating 10. Insane, guys, again, rating 10. What is this Microsoft vulnerability CVE-2020-1350, or we are known as SIGRED? It is a vulnerability impacting Windows Server which running the DNS role. By sending the DNS response more than 65,535 bytes to the vulnerable host, the attacker can run the remote command execution. And the worst scenario, attacker might able to gain the access as domain administrator. What? I think you need to take this vulnerability seriously or your day will become night. Here is the list Windows Server version affected by vulnerability CVE-2020-1350. How to get your Windows Server version? Login to your Windows Server. Run the command prompt. Type winfer. Windows Server version will pop up as per sample picture. Let me share with you how actually this vulnerability exploit your Windows DNS Server. For example, you have a DNS Server which actually cascades to external DNS Server such as 8.8.8.8 aka Google DNS or 1.1.1.1 aka Cloudflare DNS. One day, there is a query from the client who accidentally wanted to access attacker domain. Example, datu.com, which has NS record inside the malicious NS server, ns1.4444.fun. Since your DNS server does not have an entry for this domain, your DNS server will send the query to 8.8.8.8 or 1.1.1.1 and it will query to malicious NS server ns1.4444.fun to get the domain information and pass it to your DNS server. After the first query of datu.com successfully reached the malicious NS server, subsequent query, your DNS server will query directly to the malicious NS server instead of Google DNS or Cloudflare DNS. As you aware, DNS is using protocol UDP or TCP/53. For DNS message, query or response less than 512 bytes, it will use UDP/53. For above 512 bytes, will use TCP/53. From there, the malicious NS will send the DNS response with the packet size more than 65,535 bytes, more than maximum bytes allowed by the default configuration. This integer overflow leading to heap-based buffer overflow, which make the attacker can send remote command execution or RCE to gain additional privileges over your DNS server. How to fix this vulnerability CVE-2020-1350? As recommended by Microsoft, you need to install the latest patch to address how Windows Server handling such requests. The patch information can be found in Microsoft Security Advisory Portal. Please take note, restart Windows Server is required after installing the patch. How to mitigate this vulnerability CVE-2020-1350? As recommended by Microsoft, you need to make registry change to restrict the size of the largest inbound TCP-based DNS response packet that's allowed. Open the Windows registry, find the subkey /local/machine/system/current/control/set/services/DNS/parameters. Create or modify value for TCP receive packet size with type DWORD and value data hex FF00 and restart Windows DNS service. Please take note the default, which also maximum value data, is hex FFFF. The recommended value data is hex FF00, which is 255 bytes less than the default maximum. After the workaround is implemented, a Windows DNS server will unable to resolve DNS names for its client if the DNS response from the upstream server is larger than 65,280 bytes. Restart Windows server is not required after modify the registry. Thank you for watching my YouTube channel. Hopefully the information provided give you a clear understanding of the vulnerability and how to fix it. Please don't forget to subscribe to support the topics and comment at the below if you have further questions about this vulnerability. I will happy to answer the queries. Goodbye. Have a nice day.